Another book, one of my books, might talk about learning as you go into the creative life, learning who your true friends are and learning who your friendly associates are, because you lose most of your friendly associates when you make a decision to go from a rational life to a creative life. I once had a class, I gave a regular class at UCLA that was called Keeping Your Spirits Up for Creative People. And one time there were a bunch of actresses in the class, and I said, at the beginning of the class, I said, let's go around the circle and everyone introduce themselves and tell me your name and where you're from, and what is the worst question that you could be asked at a bar or a cocktail party in LA, and how do you respond to it? And one lady said, you know, she was from Arkansas, and her name was Joe, and the worst question that she had in LA was, when are you going to go back to Arkansas and work in the post office again? Mm-hmm. And I said, how do you answer that? That's terrible. And she goes, usually by bursting into tears and leaving the room. And I said, well, hopefully this class will find some help for that. The next woman said, her name was Jenny, and she was from California. And she said, and the worst question that I have is, what have you been in big lately that I've seen? And I said, yeah, that terrible question too. She goes, and I said, what is your answer? And she goes, the Pacific Ocean. And I always love that, because it showed that here's a creative person who has figured out how to protect her mind from the inevitable things that are going to happen in the big world. People are not born with sensitivity. They don't walk out of their homes on the way to a party going, I'm going to be particularly sensitive today. And the first thing they say to an actress they meet is, what have you been in bigs that I've seen? It's not because they're mean or that they're nasty people, but maybe they are, but it's probably because they aren't being sensitive. And you having that answer instantly bonds you with them and makes them respect you for respecting yourself enough to not take their question seriously. You don't ever have to answer any question that somebody gives you unless you feel like it.
Sure.
So when she answers it that way, she disarms the whole situation, whereas the first girl is not doing such a good job because she shouldn't be going to parties until she can answer that question about going back to Arkansas and working for the post office.